Hello and welcome back. Last time we learned how to calculate the difference in days between two dates. However, we entered the date in the standard American format, and that is how dates are formatted usually in your computer, no matter what type of date formatting you use on your own computer. So we entered the dates here as MM, DD, Y, Y, Y. What if people in other parts of the world like UK, Australia, India, New Zealand, when they enter the dates, they generally enter it as DD, MM, Y, Y, Y. How can you then perform calculations? So we have created here a user form with three labels: start date, end date, days difference. We have text box 1, 2, 3, and we have a command button which on click should give us the days difference even if we use another type of formatting. So we will double click on this command button and we will code this now. So we will define a few variables first. So dim date 1 as date, date 2 as date, we will define dim e row, that is the next blank row, as long. Now we will assign a value to date 1, and that will be not assigned directly from the text box, but we will format it and then assign it. So we want to format our date in the text box as DDMMYYYY, day, month, and the year. So you'll write date 1 format, parenthesis open, we have text box 1 dot text, comma, and we will write our formatting DD. MM, Y, 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 Y. That's how we want it, because we will enter the date in that format. Okay. Then we will format the date 2, which we will get from our text box 2. So date 2 will be assigned the value format text box 2.text, comma, and we'll use the same formatting. Now we also want to ensure that the date 1 is never greater than the date 2. So we will say if date 1 is greater than date 2, then set the focus on text box 1, text box 1 dot text. We'll give out a message box or a message. The start date, that is the date 1, cannot be greater than the end date, which is the date 2, and quotes close. And we will exit the sub if the user makes this mistake. And we started with an if, so we will end the if. Now we will do our further processing. So we will say in the text box 3, we need to get a value that will be date diff, we want the days and the starting date, that is date 1, comma the end date, date 2. Now if we wish to bring this data, that is the data of text box 1, text box 2, text box 3 into our worksheet, then we need to define the next blank row. So our variable E row will take the value sheet 1, because that is where we are working, dot cells rows dot count comma 1 dot end in parentheses XL up dot offset. So one row and column will remain the same, dot row. So this is how we define the E row, and we have done this many times before, so you can look it up. Now when we transfer the data from text box 1, that data has been transferred to a variable date 1. So we will say cells E row comma 1, that means the next blank row and the first column, we want to get the date 1. We can now format even this date when we get it back to our worksheet. So we can say cells E row comma 1, and we will use the same tactic, and we will say format cells E row comma 1 comma long date. Why are we taking long date, and what does long date mean? First of all, we are taking long date to avoid any ambiguity in the MM and the DD structure. So the long date is generally, you know, it would be something like January 5, 2014. Okay, that is how it will show us the date. So there will be no ambiguity. Now a similar thing we can do with the date 2. So cells E row, comma 2, that is the next blank row and the second column, we want to get the data from date 2. Okay, and we will format this value also will be assigned the value format cells E row comma 2 comma long date. If you want, you can try that out. Instead of long date, you could write DD MM YYY. That will also do the trick. However, the representation will be as a string, as a text in that format, DD MM YY. And sometimes it might create a problem. So to avoid ambiguity, we are taking the long date. Let me make this capital, because that is how the real syntax looks like. And in our column 3, we want the days difference, or difference in the number of days. So we will say cells E row, that is the next blank row and the third column, get us the value from the text box 3 dot value. So our code is now complete, and if there are no syntax errors, this should give us the results. So let's first save this. So I'll click on the save icon here. We will click on the run sub user form, and we should get our user form here. There it is. and the worksheet. So we will write here, let's say 11, 10, so that is the 11th October 2015, and our end date is, let's say, 12/11/2015. Now we want to calculate the difference in days, so we'll click here and we have an error here. Invalid use of property. So let's see what mistake we have made here, or rather what I have made here. So if date 1 is greater than date 2, then text plus 1.text, oops, that was supposed to set the focus there, so dot set focus. That means if somebody enters the start date greater than date 2, so we should get a message box. At the same time, our cursor should go to the text box 1. So we'll save this and we'll run it again. So we have our date here, 11th October 2015, that is the start date. And you see here, I've given a tooltip which shows enter text as DDMMYY. Let me show you that. See here. Do you see that? Similarly here. And this is 12th November 2015, and the calculation has been done. I can click again if you like. Okay. So we will go to our Excel worksheet. I'll just close this. Go to the Excel worksheet again, and you see here the long date, October 11th, November 12th. So there is no ambiguity here. Now, as I said, you can try that DDMMYY here instead of the long date and see what results you get. So we'll run this again. So I'm writing 11th November 2015, and here I'm writing 12th November, or let me write October, and let's see what happens. So if I click on calculate, it gives out a message, the start date cannot be greater than the end date. Okay, and you see the cursor has come there to text box 1. So I'll go here, change this to 11. So we should, there's a difference of 1 day, and let's see what happens. Calculate, and we get 1 here. We'll close this. We'll go to our Excel worksheet, and there you see November 11th. We can expand this, and that is November 12th, and the difference in days is 1. I hope you found this useful. Thanks for watching.